Where's your bed? Let's go take a look at it.
For Wendy Dwyer, volunteering at the Our House shelter for the working homeless is a long-held ambition.
Hey, you'll be on camera if you get in bed.
She's one of a network of paid volunteers in a government-funded anti-poverty program that's now run out of cash. Wendy's annual salary isn't much, and she's already relying on friends and family to help her stay here. Like many in her position, she's worried about what will happen if she's forced to leave.
Meals wouldn't be served, and children would not have the same day-to-day contact that they do that gives them stability. Things could change for the worse for the people who are most at risk.
Homeless shelters across the U.S. rely heavily on funding from the federal government to keep their doors open. For now, Our House is solvent but will face serious problems the longer the partial shutdown goes on.
This is hurting the least among us. This is hurting homeless families and their children who are not going to have a meal, who are not going to have a safe space for their children to be so that they can work their way out of homelessness.
Across Little Rock, the effects of the partial shutdown are steadily being felt. And for local government official Richard Weiss, the message for politicians in Washington is simple.
Quit playing games, get back to work, do what the people, do what your constitutional responsibilities are. Pay attention to your oath of office and follow it. Real simple.
The fact that people here in Little Rock are frustrated won't come as a surprise. It's a feeling replicated across the entire country. But it's when you see the very real effects on those who depend on government programs to survive that you begin to understand that emotion. While politicians squabble, the needy and those that help them will soon begin to suffer. And for many, that is simply unacceptable. Andy Gallagher, Al Jazeera, Little Rock, Arkansas.